Chapter 68. Two hermits stopped the army. Virtue of the Pure Void found himself in an awkward position when Huang Tianhua asked about his future. It would discourage his disciple should he tell the truth, but disaster would unavoidably fall should he not. He used this riddle as a warning. Avoid a man named Gao. Do not linger with him. Atop the golden chicken range. Bees fly in a swarm. Achieve great things and be remembered for 1,000 years. Ignore my warning. And you'll suffer in the calamity ahead. The riddle was not the warning the immortal intended, for Huang Tianhua was young, bold, and heroic. Earth traveler Sun posed the same question to Krakukanda. The immortal felt sad, as he knew that his disciple would lose his life at the hand of Zhang Kui. He also recited a riddle. Skilled in traveling underground, you must be careful on the way. Before the cliff, a pool of blood. A beast will bite you to death in surprise. After Earth Traveler Sun thanked his master, all the immortals bade farewell to Jiang Ziya and returned to their various mountains. King Wu, Jiang Ziya, and all the generals returned to West Qi City to prepare for the expedition in 3 days. The following day, Jiang Ziya went to see King Wu and presented him with a memorial. When King Wu finished reading it, Jiang Ziya bowed and said, "The late king graced me with great honor, and you have treated me likewise. I'll do everything I can to return your favor. We'll soon start on our march eastward, and I would like your highness to join us. If that is what heaven expects me to do, I will certainly go." King Wu said, "But when will we start? We must finish our preparations and drill the army. We'll then pick a lucky date to set off. I'll inform you when we know." Jiang Ziya replied. King Wu entertained him and both drank happily that day. At the fifth watch the next morning, Jiang Ziya went to Mount Qi and ascended the terrace. Cannons were fired and the beat of drums rang out in the early morning. Muster was called. "We have 600,000 men. We need at least 4 vanguard generals." Jiang Ziya thought, reviewing the troops. He ordered, "Let Nengong Kuo, Wu Ji, Neja, and Huang Tianhua come to see me." When the generals ascended the terrace and bowed before him, the 4 generals nodded their agreement. As the result of the lot, Huang Tianhua was appointed the front vanguard general, Nengong the left, Wu Ji the right, and Neja the rear. Jiang Ziya handed each of them a seal and fixed red flowers on their chests. They each drank a cup of wine, thanked Jiang, and left the terrace. Jiang Ziya then ordered that Yang Jian, Earth Traveler Sun, and Zhang Lun take care of supply transportation. Yang Jian was assigned by lot to the first run, Earth Traveler Sun to the second, and Zhang Lun to the third. Jiang Ziya toasted each with 3 cups of wine and put red flowers on their chests. He then called a roll of other generals, Huang Feihu, Huang Feibiao, Huang Feibao, Huang Ming, Zhou Ji, Long Huan, Wu Qin, Huang Tianlu, Huang Tianji, Huang Tianxian, Ximian, Tai Dian, Hong Yao, Qigong, Ying Xun, Mao Gongsui, Zhou Gongdan, Xiao Gongxu, Bi Gonggao, Bo Da, Bo Xu, Zhong Tu, Zhong Hu, Xu Yi, Xu Xia, Ji Sui, Ji Gua, and 20 or so others. Including Thunderbolt, King Wen had 100 sons by 24 imperial concubines. 36 were trained in military affairs, and 16 lost their lives on the battlefield. There were also the generals from King Zhou's camp, Deng Zhougeng, Tai Luan, Deng Xiu, Zhao Shen, Su Yanheng, Chao Tian, Chao Lei, Hong Jin, Ji Kang, Su Hu, Su Chizhong, Zhao Bing, Sun Ziyu, Princess Long Ji, and Deng Chanyu. When muster call was over, Jiang Ziya ordered, "Let General Huang Feihu ascend the terrace." When General Huang had bowed before him, he declared, "Though the Shang dynasty is doomed, we must still proceed cautiously, as there remain generals greatly skilled in magic. General Huang, you will drill the army." The next day, Jiang went to see King Wu in the palace and said, "We are now ready and will set off soon. Who would you trust with internal affairs while we are away?" I recommend Sun Yisheng. He's a very trustworthy minister. Zhao replied. And who would you trust with external affairs? General Huang Gun has much experience. I recommend him to deal with all military affairs. I'm delighted by your recommendations. King Wu responded. King Wu retired to the inner palace to see his mother. He reported. Jiang Ziya is going to meet all the nobles at Mengjin, and I have been requested to join them. I won't be there long. It is right that you should go. Just follow the commander's directions. His mother said. She ordered a farewell dinner to entertain her son. The next day they set off. When King Wu got to the Chengting Pavilion, his imperial brothers toasted both him and Jiang Ziya, wishing them success. The army marched on in high spirits. It was the 24th day of the third month in the 30th year of King Zhou. Passing by Mount Yan and Mount Shouyang, the army was suddenly blocked by two Taoists, Bo Yi and Shu Qi. They stood in the middle of the road to halt the advance of the army. Though they disliked King Zhou, they were not in favor of attacking him and bringing him down. Take us to see your commander at once. They demanded. Jiang Ziya and King Wu rode forward to greet the two Taoists. How do you do, Your Highness, Prime Minister? They said politely. Both King Wu and Jiang Ziya bowed. We beg your pardon that we can't return your greeting with full salutation as we are in armor. Why do you stop us? Where are you going? The two asked. King Zhou is evil, and so King Wu is going to carry out the punishment as decreed by heaven. All the nobles have united in this cause. Jiang Ziya replied. A son should never mention his father's faults and a minister never expose his master's wickedness. We have never heard of a king being attacked by his subjects. King Zhou now is the supreme ruler. Though he is wicked, we can only try our best to persuade him to repent. Don't you remember that your late king was his loyal subject and complained not once all his whole life? It is said that great virtue can touch the heart of the wicked and great love can win even the savages along the borders. If you are virtuous, you can turn the wicked into good. It would be better to remain loyal. Bo Yi and Shu Qi remonstrated. King Wu remained silent, but Jiang Ziya replied. I see your point, but it is too short-sighted. No trace of virtue can now be found in the crown. Heaven above is angry, and the people below are murmuring. This crisis is as serious as if the sky were falling, the earth splitting, and the four seas boiling. Heaven does everything as the people wish. We have been entrusted by heaven with this duty, and we'll be guilty if we do not behave as heaven expects. We must send our army to settle the matter, or else we'll be opposing both heaven and the people. The generals saw that Bo Yi and Shu Qi were talking on like this to delay them. They grew angry, and Bo Yi and Shu Qi could see their displeasure. They grabbed the reins to stop King Wu and Jiang, saying, "We'll return the grace of our late king and do our best as loyal ministers. Your Highness is known for your virtue, but how can you use violence so soon after your father has passed away? You are not a filial son. You are not a loyal minister either, as you are on your way to attack the king. You'll be condemned by later generations." The generals were enraged to see King Wu and Jiang Ziya held up by these two. They wanted to kill them at once, but Jiang Ziya stopped them. "Don't hurt them. They are righteous men." He told his guards to set them free. After the army had occupied Jiaoga, Bo Yi and Shu Qi felt ashamed to eat the grain grown in the new Zhou dynasty. They withdrew to the mountains to live on wild vegetables and grass. When they reached the Golden Chicken Range, another army with red flags appeared before them on the summit of the mountain. The sentinels reported this to Jiang Ziya. "Tell the army to set up camp here," Jiang ordered. "Find out which army it is that blocks our advance. Who would like to meet him?" Jiang Ziya asked when it was reported that an enemy general had challenged their army. Nengongkuo responded. "I will. It is our first combat. You must do your best, but be very careful." Jiang warned. Nangong mounted his horse and rushed from the camp with a roar of cannons. He saw a general in iron armor on a black horse with a long lance. Where does your damned army come from? How dare you stop us? Nangong Kuo roared roughly. Who are you? Where are you going? Wei Ben, the other general, asked. By order of heaven, we're on our way to attack King Zhou, the tyrant. How dare you hinder our advance? Nangong Kuo yelled loudly. He attacked Wei Ben, but after 30 rounds, he felt exhausted, his back was drenched in sweat. It's unfortunate to meet this general in the very first battle. I'll be seriously dealt with if I am defeated. He thought to himself. As he was not concentrating on the battle, Wei Ben had the chance to grab his belt and capture him. I won't hurt you. Return and tell Commander Jiang to see me immediately. Wei Ben said. Jiang Ziya was furious. He yelled. You are the left vanguard general. Your defeat only boosts the morale of the enemy and discourages our own. You dare to see me shamelessly, a captive set free by the enemy. He then ordered. Bind him up and behead him at once. When he saw that Nangong Kuo was going to lose his head, Wei Ben roared loudly. Don't hurt him. Let me see Commander Jiang. I have something important to say to him. Jiang Ziya swore angrily when he heard the report, but decided to go out and look for himself. The generals rode out in pairs under big red banners. Who are you expecting to see me here? Jiang Ziya asked. Admiring Jiang Ziya's dignified stance and the soldiers' strict discipline, Wei Ben realized the greatness of West Qi. He dismounted, knelt on the roadside, and said, I have come and venture to offer my service in the hope that my name will be recorded in history. I dared not join you straight away, but now I have seen you and your army with my own eyes, I beg you to accept me. Admitted into the camp, Wei Ben knelt before Jiang Ziya again and said, I have learned how to wield a lance and ride a horse, yet I have never found a good master. I am happy to meet King Wu and you now, and hope that I may be able to serve you. Jiang Ziya was delighted. Wei Ben, who was still bowing on his knees, continued. Please forgive General Nangong Kuo, Commander. Though Nangong Kuo was defeated, we are lucky to have General Wei with us now. Jiang said and ordered. Set the general free. When Nangong Kuo thanked Jiang for his mercy, the commander said solemnly. As an old minister and head of the generals, you deserve death for your defeat in the first battle. We forgive you this time because General Wei Ben has joined our force. Let General Wei Ben take your post as the left vanguard general, and you stay with me. Han Rong, commander of Sishui Pass, had sent an urgent report to Zhao Ge discussing the death of General Jiang Shun and Jiang Ziya's swift march towards the capital. Prince Wei Zi anxiously read the report, and then went into the inner palace to see King Zhou. King Zhou was greatly alarmed and immediately held court. He approved Fei Lian's recommendation to appoint Kong Shun of Sanshan Pass to attack the West Qi forces. Kong Shun was well trained in magic. When he received his appointment, Kong Shun worshipped the great banners, led 100,000 men out of Sanshan Pass, and was soon at Sishui Pass. He was met by Han Rong. You're already a little late, Commander? Han Rong said. What do you mean by that, General? Kong Shun asked. Jiang Ziya has already been appointed commander, and his army left West Qi on the 15th day of the third month. Han Rong replied. What is he to be afraid of? I'll take him, King Wu, and his generals and drag them all to Zhao Ge for trial. Kong Shun said proudly. He then ordered. Open your pass gate at once. I'll march westward. 2 days later at the Golden Chicken Range, Kong Shun discovered that Jiang Ziya had arrived some time earlier. He ordered his army to set up camp and prepare for the first battle. If you want to know what happened, please read the next chapter.